Hi all, all hi. Bonjour, konnichiwa, ni ha, salam aleikum, sawadi kap, yesh kemesh. Que passe, zdravo, good day, shalom, namaste, how was one, how was all? I'm Cannabus Ted, and I had to medicate with cannabis instead of getting out of my head on Big Pharma's meds. Happy 4th of July to all of my American fam. Celebrating the 4th of July. Happy Canada Day the other day to all my Canadian fam. I hope that yous all remembered what that revolution was about in the first place. Like I told you all this last year on the CBD News 420. If you don't know about the CBD News 420, you need to check out Dick and Fanny Fitzwell because they do and they're great. And like, they told us all last year all about the truth behind the revolution, the American Revolution, when they went to kick out the King of England. Because the King of England was about to tax the shizzle out of the hemp crops, the cannabis crops, you know what I mean? Can't have that cannabis being free. No, kings don't like that. So, you know, George Washington, John Adams and a few of his mates all got together and that went, no, we're not having this. We're not having this. I got the mate Loon there down in Texas. He went up and he saw Chad in Boston and that. And went down and saw Joe and Izzy. And went, look, what we need to do is we have this tea party. We're going to have a tea party up at Boston there. We'll go on the ships and we'll chuck all the king's tea and hemp into the sea. They call it the tea party to distract you with the tea. Show them the tea. And they ignore the fact that it was the cannabis that they were really fighting about. I just thought I'd come and remind everybody about that and do a little late night wake and bake. I've been having a bit of a day off. Knocking off some videos, some footage I've been catching. So please go and check them out on my YouTube channel, the CannaBusTeD on YouTube, or the CannaBusTeD page on Facebook. Mixing down stuff with Andy last night. He's off camping tonight. I wanted to go, but I'd sort of ripping me back yesterday walking through Durham, so I had to lay flat today. But hey, welcome everyone. If you don't know, I'm registered blind, so I have to use this little magnifying device to enlarge this magnified device right here, because I'm pretty short on the sight these days, but it's all right, I've got a second sight that keeps me going. Hi Jeremy, evening bro. Hey Shaka, shout out to the Save the World Army. I've just been sat watching the General Smoking Joe over there on the Save the World Army page. Go and hit up that page like immediately. You might as well go and do it now if you want to know about some truth and some, you know, interesting, meet some great people, some true warriors out there fighting to bring love and peace to the world through positive action. Go and check out General Joe and the Save the World Army and the Zulu Squad and the OG Squad and all of the chapters of the Save the World Army. The Worldwide Weed Army is indeed a chapter of the Save the World Army. And check them out. Check out the stuff that they talk about, because they talk about some pretty real stuff. Crazy old week this week, going through the internet, isn't it? Facebook breaking because it's, you know, it's tagging everybody's pictures and adding too much data to it all. Hi to the kings and queens, how goes it, Brian? Happy 4th of July, bro. Hey, Richard, all right, mate? Oi, oi. I'm doing good, mate, I'm doing good. I forgot to check if you were the Richard that I spoke to in that cushy calf. I was a bit stoned that day. I like to get stoned, mate. I like to smoke the weed. And chill with my guitar and that. Tell people about how this I used to, like Richard there, he's from my hometown. And I was born and bred in Hartlepool. I met a lass in the Colliery's when I was about 16, just turned 16. And had kids pretty young. Left Hartlepool and came to live up here for a bit with my kids, and when my son was like 10, I went back to Hartlepool around 99, 2000, around there. And all of my old friends that I'd grown up with, lots of them had turned to drugs, like hardcore heroin and big pharmaceutical drugs. And I met a girl when I moved back, and after a few months of seeing this lass, she admitted to me, like, you know, she was using drugs. So for a bit there, I was trying to get it off the drugs, and if we'd had to take her away to the lakes for a few days, she'd do a cold take, we'd come home, first chance she gets, she'd be out buying drugs. And I couldn't understand that. I'd give her mushrooms, she'd go and watch sunrises, and we'd have these great conversations about how we, you know, addiction's just like a crutch for all of these issues that we have in our lives. This was like my sort of psychology kind of breaking down of her issues. And she'd struggled with racism in that town all of her life, and that she had these issues, and I was trying to help her deal with the issues, but she was just an addict. And I couldn't understand the addiction, so I thought it would be a good idea, because I'm clever like that. So I thought, hey, if I get on them and on that heroin, we're there, if I smoke this heroin for a couple of weeks, and I know what the cold turkey feels like, and I'm sure through me getting off it, I'll be like, hey, look, this is how you get off it, this is what you have to do. So I smoked it straight every day with her, and I let her come out openly and use her drugs around me, kind of welcomed her addiction into my life and became the addict. And I knew what was happening to me, and I felt it, and I tried to battle against it, but it just all logic went out the window. And after like 17 years of living back in Hartlepool, injecting into every vein I could find around my body, dying a few times and that, and crashing into the back of the bus full of tablets and breaking me back in three places, and then taking a couple of other tablets and ending up with brain damage and waking up in a hospital 17 years later thinking, what have I just done with the last almost 20 years of my life? I realised I needed to make a change, and that was when I started using the cannabis more medicinally, and I used it to replace the drugs that I became ingrained in, that became my daily existence, my hourly, minute by minute existence. And I replaced them all with the plant, and it's pretty much saved my life. So I've been telling people on the Facebookness of Faceness that this is the way out. Blue cheese, oh lovely, lovely. I'm just gonna sit and have a chill before bed. Hi Joshua, what's up bro? Hey bud. Yeah, it started glitching on me, that's why I came out myself, Shaka. Hey Robin, much love to you sister, much love to Robin. So I met people through this Facebook. They just had like a... They said something at the right time to me at different times as I was on this journey of recovery. And like some people encouraged me more to share my story on the Facebook. And then I started playing the music and Kate, and came across people like Shaka and that. They encouraged me to play more of the music. So I really got into this stuff. It helped me start making videos, writing songs again. So I started finding passion again in my life. I shared that video, it's like it was from a TED talk, where a guy talks about how addiction stems really from segregation, mostly, and being socially outcast because, you know, we have struggles, every one of us has struggles, and we all find different ways to deal with it. And addicts have just found, you know, the rough way. And we need to kind of help them. So I try to help as much as I can. Says Richard, there's a way out. All my mates in Hartlepool, you know, I still have lots of friends in Hartlepool that are using. I don't go down to the town as much. You know, if I do, I'm in and out, or I'm with the friends that I know that don't use any kind of drugs. But it's been like two and a half years since I last used heroin. It's been that long. I've got this little rat's tail at the back of my head. You can see. So, you know, when I die, I can test this and I'll see there's no heroin in this hair. There was most of my life, but in this air, no. This is methadone free. So I got off all that big pharma stuff and replaced it with this. And yeah, sometimes I want to get pissed, or I want to get fucked up, or I want to just sleep for a week. I get those thoughts a lot. But I don't get the old ones so much. I can joke about the old ones. I used to be like, oh, look, I've been clean for this. I can have a treat. I don't treat myself anymore because I kept dying. Kept fucking me up. So I've gave up all that stuff. Parkinson's patient, right? I've seen how it helps with Parkinson's. I've seen people with some really devastating shakes. I have a friend, like I met a lad when I came to like a CBT course, a cognitive behavioural therapy course. which kind of led to the name CannaBusTeD. All of this stuff kind of came at the same time. I was going there, and there's a guy with Tourette's, and he's like, he's got these tics. And I was learning about cannabis, and I saw this Russian guy with Tourette's who smoked cannabis, and it stopped his. He was like proper shaking, looked more like Parkinson's than Tourette's. And he was smoking cannabis. And it eased off all of his shakes and stopped his tics, his verbal tics. So I was like saying to this lad at this drugs recovery course. Most of the people in there are in recovery, alcoholics and things, and he'd had issues with drinking in the past and that. And we're all talking, and I'm like, have you ever considered, because he was on methadone, he was actually on methadone for Tourette's. I'd never heard of that, but this guy was on there. So I was like, have you ever considered cannabis? You know, it's a, oh, I'm not smoking that wacky backy man drugs, you know what I mean? I've got issues with drugs. So I had a big issue when I first came to this, saying that cannabis is not a drug, it's a plant, and it is a plant. But it also is a mind-altering substance. And it was because of him, it was because of this negative viewpoint, because it's been categorised as a drug for the last 100 years. People are believing it to be a dangerous narcotic. So I like to tell people the truth, that it's not dangerous. It's not a narcotic. It is, it's hard to give up anything, Jeremy, when you've done it for a long time. Hi, Bri, how goes it, bro? Much love always, man. One step at a time. What's up, John Wayne Priest? My brother, the Blaze Priest and family, one of the very first people that welcomed me into the family groups and things. Mad love to you, Priest. He's out there in Montana now, Cali born and bred. I've been going live more on this profile. People, if you want to go and hit your notifications up on the page too, I'd really appreciate it. I do Funky Freaky Friday lives over there. Hit up Smoke Nation Worldwide too, I do lives on there. And all of the groups. One drink at a time, Jeremy, if you can keep beating the temptation. One love, one respect worldwide, High Priest. He is the High Priest, isn't he? Everyone show Richard some love, he's from my hometown, so he knows the struggle only too well, because that town over the last 20 years especially is really, the nature of the town has just altered so much. It's always been a little rough, but it's getting such a bad press, and the whole area is, and it's all because of these dangerous big pharma style drugs. You have the same truck as mine. I'm trying so hard, try easy. I used to try hard all the time to quit the heroin. This time, I'm doing it this time. Then I just started giving myself a break. And I kept reminding myself every time I'd gone an hour, because an hour at a time for me without using that heroin or taking a diazepam. I was injecting the 16th of heroin, a shot. I was pretty bad on it then. And it wasn't until I started giving myself a break and like, saying, all right, yeah, I fucked up. But I have to learn not to and keep moving past it, and it's tough. But you need to, what helped me, Jeremy, was constructing something. I like to create stuff. I used to be a musician years ago, into sound engineering and all that. And going back to my old hobbies and the person I was before I was an addict, the person before I started all that, I had a couple of years there when I was working at 50 the front, that I was drinking every day for 2 years, like from morning till night, non-stop. Waking up, cooking 16 breakfasts with the DTs. Like. And that was okay for me then. I didn't see that as that much of an issue, because I just came from heroin addiction, and I replaced it with alcohol at the time, which to me felt like a lesser of an evil, till it started having an impact on my health. And then I realised that, you know, as we get older, we don't have the resilience that we used to have. So, you know, to be honest, I quit the drink and got back on the heroin for a few years. That was like when I last had a bad relapse. But I decided to make a promise to my family and friends on Facebook that if I did relapse, if I used any kind of substance, that I would let people know and I would stream it and I would post about it. And because if I'm gonna, it's pointless me lying. I've done that as an addict. Like you meet other addicts in the street and you're like, they come up to you, all right there, John. How are you doing? I haven't seen you for ages. Oh, I'm doing great. I'm finally off the drugs. Oh, you're off the drugs, all right. Oh, well, so-and-so's had some shit anyway. You don't want none of that shit. I've been doing all right, you know, I've had a bit of a dabble and that, and in my head, I'm like, yeah, so bad, but I'm lying to another addict. Who knows I'm lying? And it just becomes like second nature to just deny that you're on drugs, deny it, because you just get judged anyway and people look down on you. You know, drugs aren't biased at all. Drugs will select anybody from any background. I saw Tabasco Tammy in earlier. I loved her live this week, man. Take it easy, mate. Enjoy. You too. Have a great sleep tonight, Richard. Enjoy that blue cheese. Pain. We have to do what we have to do. Like, I'm in pain every single day, Brian, and I would so love to just have a day off and get a couple of diazes, get a couple of DFs, you know, something just have a day off, just one day off. Oh, wouldn't that be great to not have any niggle and knots in my spine, because I've got three shattered vertebrae in my back. Like, well, obviously won't still be shattered, but however, the V is, it's not very comfortable. But I know if I let myself do it the once, what's to stop me doing it the twice? It's never stopped me before. Every time before, when I said, oh, that's just a treat, that's just a one-off. It's always been, well, I was all right after that one-off. I was all right last week when I had a one-off. Why don't I have another one-off this week? I was all right yesterday when I had a one-off. Why don't I just have another one-off today? You know what I mean? Oh, I was all right 10 minutes ago when I had one off. I might as well have another one. And it just snowballed. Anyway, I wanted to sit and have a little practice through the songs I've been doing the last couple of weeks, me writing and learning. Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. Why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something wrong, now I long for yesterday. Love was such an easy game to play, but now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Hey, Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart, then you can start to make it better. Hey, you were made to time you feel the pain, hey Jude, refrain. Don't carry the world upon your shoulders. 'Cause don't you know that it's a fool who plays it cool by making his world a little colder. Me trying to learn to sing last night. Singing is such a hard thing to do. To do properly. Massive props to Andy for like bellowing 2 a.m. last night trying to do this stuff. Sorry I missed comments, peeps, I hate that. Hi Luan, happy 4th of July. Do you know the true history of the 4th of July? Did you know that the war of independence, the Revolutionary War of America, that was actually to free the cannabis? Did you know that? That's not just cannabis propaganda, that's true propaganda there. That's exactly what it was. George Washington, he was a hemp farmer. And the King of England, he'd raise the taxes on the colonies, which it was at the time. It was the colonies of the UK, and you know, we owned your ass. You worked for us, you grew our fruits, you grew our hemp, what we use to make all of the ropes and the canvases and all of this amazing stuff that you can make from that plant. Yeah, like we colonised that country using ships that were powered by the cannabis plant, with sailors that were powered by the cannabis plant, because, you know, there was gruel. Gruel was a popular dish back in them days because it was high in protein and omega-3 and omega-6. It was made with cannabis seed. Yeah, so it was like the fuel of the world. And when the king raised the taxes on the colonies and we wanted more of your cannabis from yous, then, like, you know, George and the lads, they went, no, we're not having that. And they even wrote the Declaration of Independence on paper made from the plant. It was like a message to history that you, lest you ever forget. But, you know, people forget, don't they? Because we have a tea party instead every year. So that's the truth anyway. Happy 4th of July, Deborah. The Beatles. I'm bankrupt at the moment. The priest is bankrupt. No, that's no good. One packet is one price. One packet of what, Gerda? I hope you're not telling Wayne on me thing. You know what I mean? Don't be doing that. Hey Jeff Oaks, much love to the Sativa Cross fam. How you feeling, man? I saw that Bongho Leo got escorted with Lefty from a council meeting last week. It could have been this week. I haven't had much sleep this week, so my brain's been a bit all over the place. Crazy stuff. Oh wow, thank you, priest. Come do that on my page, bro. Thank you to everybody that shares all of your time, that's constantly there for me. Before I do my Sativa Cross song, I'm going to have a practice. This is a song I wrote the other night, early hours. So I'm trying to drill the words into my head. Shadows dance across the moon. By chance, I found you. shared a glance. She came into the room. I caught your eye, a deeper shade of blue. And looking back, I can see exactly how I fell in love with you. You were there whenever I needed someone's help to get through. Thick or thin, you had my back from the beginning. You helped me grin through all of the sadness I've seen. You helped me win through all of the sad times there's been. Going out to celebrate, it's date night, and I can barely wait to see your face. I miss my bus, now I'm running late. I better rush, I'm running, don't want to make you wait. And it looks like there could be rain. I'm pulling up, I see your reflection in the window pane. You look up, and your smiling eyes melt my heart again. Maybe a woman at a stove, baking bread or making rice, or just boiling down some bones. If I were a drone, get fat, the buffalo are gone and the mountaintops are black. The trout in the streams are all hermaphrodite. You lean to the left and you walk to the right, and it feels like deja vu. The sun goes down and I'm still missing you. Counting the cost of another love lost, but under my gold stream and circular balls, a 99 cent worth of stoners and fools. It feels like deja vu. Haven't I just sung this song to you? Thank you.
floating. Isn't it fun on a rock around the sun, just floating? Wishing it all was a lie and you're not going to die, just wishing. Knowing there is nothing to know, so just let it go. Knowing and hoping that there is a divine and you're not left behind, just hoping.
One of Andy's old ones I've been rehashing. That's a high one. Nice. Long live Bong Ho Leo, you know it. Does UK have 99 cent stores? No, we have pound shops. We have pound land. It's probably the same crap though. Cancer foods, all the bright coloured packages that you know will probably give you cancer if you eat it. And then cheap, really poorly made products from China, which is why China's like sort of rich right now, isn't it? Selling us all of this cheap tat. For some reason, in the pound lands, in the pound shops, because we don't have dollars here, we have pounds. We don't have euros neither, we have pounds. We said not the euro, no. They sell like, they did, like CDs, like top great CDs, what I loved growing up and that. And they're like all cheap, just for £1. I think that was just because, you know, the CD system had kind of collapsed, hadn't it? CDs like, you know, out of date now and it's all downloading that. So they probably just had to sell all of them CDs. What cost them like 5p, five pennies, whatever, I don't know what Americans have. Like a 5 pence is nothing. It's like 100 pennies in a pound. 5 pence that used to cost to make a CD, and I'm talking like the cost of the CD. So a CD that you would pay between £12.99 and £15 dollars, whatever it was you would pay. Well, that CD only cost like a tiny little fraction of the cost, and that's like the cost of the CD, the band's cost for recording the album, the studio time, the packaging, the advertisement. That's like all inclusive, just 5p each. And they used to sell them to us for 15. And then downloads came out and went, oh no, it's gonna crash. And they just started selling us it for a little bit cheaper online.
I'm just chilling like Bob Dylan, killing time and feeling fine. So please don't curb my enthusiasm, cause a tiny step can be a giant chasm. And ignorance is no excuse to know the truth. It's up to you, so always choose the safer route, and only use a sacred fruit, cause they shall grow if you don't know. Ignorance is no excuse. There's no excuse. our nurse is true. That's no excuse. Forgive them, Jeff, they know or not what they do.
Shout out to Jeff, man. Jeff was in hospital after a major operation. And the nurse, like, Jeff is like lots of members of the Sativa Cross, Ignorance is No Excuse family, that choose not to use, that big pharma route. It doesn't work for them. They just want to use natural based medicines like cannabis. He was brought in some gummies that contained THC. And the nurse took them from this medical cannabis patient. That's a bit crazy, isn't it? Find that very crazy. Hi Gary Godfrey, much love to you, brother, long time no see. Gary, there's another patient, and he was told that if he had cannabis in his system, he wouldn't be eligible for, was it a liver or kidney transplant? I don't remember, Gary, it's been a while, bro. My memory's not where it was, you know, Big Pharma fried that. Well, I think it was liver transplant. They said, no, we're not gonna do that. If you've got cannabis in your system, no. So, you know, this prohibition is causing the suffering of thousands of people around the world, and that's why I'm so passionate about it. 100 pennies in an American dollar, well, a penny is like one of your pennies, 1.5 of your pennies, I think. There's about $130 to £100. Something like that, usually. Hi, Gay Nana OG. Hope you've all had a great one. I'm not big on government. You know, I think we can look after ourselves. We're all adults. We look after ourselves better than they are. We have an NHS here, built by the people, staffed by the people. And it's just hemorrhaging money. But they want to privatise it, they want to sell it to the biggest bidders. Hence Mr. Trump's visit. Come over here to try and buy our medical system and privatise it. Like everybody's entitled to care in this country. If you're a resident of this country, you get care. If you have an accident, you don't have to pay insurance. It's there for us. We all chip in to get that. I finally learned the chords to it, Deborah. That's a high one, the highest I know. It's the highest I know. It's Andrew, man. It's all Andrew's fault. Everyone can blame Andy for all this. He's been learning, we've been watching loads of singing coach and stuff on YouTube. And it's like, it's exercise, isn't it? And I always done it anyway, but it's like, it's just worse going on. And it's hard to do, like, because to hit them high notes, you're supposed to like really open up and let them out. There is ways like to falsetto, like, like to proper sing them. You want to let them out, and I have difficulty with that. It's very self-conscious and hard to let that open up in a flat when maybe my neighbours came and I haven't heard them. I don't want to be, there's people watching me on Facebook, like the nerves and things. I try to combat them by making ridiculously high songs that I'll never be able to do and really hurt people's ears probably. I'm trying to get I always wanted to sing my entire life. I just want to sing. I love singing, but I've always had this voice that causes pain, really. It's not so bad since the brain damage and the confidence sort of filter being a bit more broken. I've opened up a lot more, but I'm going to dig out some old stuff and show you where I used to sing. Struggle is, can you hear, this song's perfect for it. There's a position in the voice. There's a tune where you're singing here, which is what Andy was having if you look at this last night, you're singing all from here. And where it comes to here, or you sing from here, and it's like it's finding the balance in the verses. He sings from like here. And I can only really sing from here and here. I don't have the middle ground. Sundown, that's like down here where sundown reminds you of concreted skies. You thought you were flying, but you opened your eyes and you found yourself falling. And then it goes into that, and you've got to sing from the stomach, but I want to hear you, and I'm not a singer. Whatever you want to be, you can be, can't you? So you just got to practice. You rock. Thank you, girl. I'll make your ears rock. Sometimes, especially like late on a night like these. It's about the modern world. It's about 5G. It's about family and people. Sunlight at sunrise, sunshine, open your eyes. Don't lie there and while away the day. It's time that we must fly off to a new horizon and a brand new sky across the hills. Be more like Jack and Jill and find the will to get along. High rise like high fives, where Wi-Fi
defy disguise. City lights and drunken fights, like OG number 5. Don't be hypnotized by all the lies. For a better view, look deep inside. You were born with human rights and human wrongs. You were born with human rights and human wrongs. Moonlight on a bright night is a sight for sore eyes. Star signs and ley lines, campfires by a riverside. I won't hide, I'll feel alive. I'll live my life like I'm still a child, learning the difference between what is right and who is wrong. Learning the difference between who is wrong and what is right. Learning the difference between being weak and growing strong. Learning the difference between smoking it in a blunt or hitting it in a star signs and ley lines, campfires by a river. The original number 5. Number 5, that's a clever line, that. That whole line, I'm proud of punching that line. High rise are like hi-fis that wear Wi-Fi disguises. City lights and drunken fights like OG number 5. OG number 5. Johnny number 5, Johnny 5. Short circuit. I'm singing about the circuitry and the 5G all in one line. Like, just clever. I'm just such a clever poet, you know. Hi, Patty. I'm just bigging myself up. Just blow me on trumpet. I wrote that last week. And I'm just making sure the people know what it's about. Don't be hypnotized by all the lies. For a better view, look deep inside. You were born with human rights and human wrongs. They're coming and running and trolling the world. The bankers, the wankers, the global cartel. With their money and bullshit, it's all I can smell. Through the television and the fake news they sell. To each one, reach 1,000, change 1,000,000. To each one, reach 1,000, change within. Cause there's something going on I could not fail to overlook. There are more lies in the sky than there are in a holy book. Planes are flying high, the world is run by crooks. Before running my mind, I find nobody gives a fuck. Cause they're all stuck looking at a screen. They're all so stuck hooked on Facebook me. And all these social networks can work just like a net, catching on your free thoughts till there's no free thinkers left. With everybody striving to be part of a crowd, when you go and fit in, they turn around and push you out. Cause they're all stuck looking at a screen. So stuck, what happened to the dream? To each one, reach 1,000, change 1,000,000. To each one, reach 1,000, change within. Infowars and nanotech are locking doors inside your head. Alex Jones and David Icke are on a stolen motorbike. Running from the CIA, the FBI and NSA. It's okay, they're KKK, working for the DEA. And no one listens anyway to a single word I say. I could say that Trump is gay, he probably is anyway. When I stop and take a look, I see nobody gives a fuck. Seems to me that they're all stuck looking at a screen. Facebook me, it's like a lucid dream.
InfoWars and Nanotech. I'm gonna smoke another joint before I go to bed. Yeah, yeah, I built a couple while I was watching the Save the World Army. As you do. I think I'll smoke the little one. Don't want to be on too long. I've had a rough one on my back, you know what I mean? I don't want to set it off again. Hey Kaz, how you doing? She's straight in here with the pineapples, look. I've got to watch my queens out there with them pineapples. I've had some funny experiences with them pineapples. My handsome devil. Hey beautiful, how you doing? How you doing? Hey Chuckles. Smoking from New Jersey. Shout out to I love loads New Jersey, man. I've got loads of fam in New Jersey. Them that do that song that I sent you the link to, that Chucky does dabs and he don't care. Chucky does dabs and he don't care. Chucky does dabs. Like, they're all from New Jersey, Lefty and them. Oh, come on, you blind man. Shout out to Sativa Cross, ignorance is no excuse. In fact, a lot of the people in this song that I'm going to do right now. Of New Jersey, from New Jersey. Living in New Jersey, lived in New Jersey. This song's called Busted. And it was written by Mr. Lefty Grimes. In fact, let me stick some harp on this little awesome song that Lefty wrote. Song what Lefty wrote. This is my little secret stash of harps again, this little thing. Oh no. That's not. What have I done with that then? Oh, that's not the one I'm talking about today, is it? Wayne was in the van when he was stopped by the man. He was busted. And Carolyn Lodi, well, she was just getting high and she got busted. And the weed man from down south, well, he'd been running his mouth. And the police came in and ransacked his house, all because of a red on the couch. He was busted. They were busted. CannaBusTeD. Anthony in Summit had some tinted glass and he got busted. Lefty was in Linden acting like an ass when he got busted. David in Keyport, well, they stole all his glass. They took all his money and seized all his stash. While Mike was on his bike, getting his head beat and bashed. They were busted. They were busted. Thank you. Chris and Epstein gone. They took her wheelchair when she got busted. She had to shit into a bucket because the police didn't care when she got busted. And Jessie was just growing some weed in her home. The police spent time and money wiretapping her phone. They took Jeremy, now Joanne's all alone. They were busted. They were busted. CannaBusTeD. They were busted. CannaBusTeD. They were busted. Should I run for president? Mother, should I trust the government? Mother, will they put me in the firing line? Hush now, baby, baby, don't you cry. Mother's gonna check out all your girlfriends for you. Mother won't let anyone dirty get through. Mother's gonna keep you right here under her wing. She won't let you fly, but she might let you see. Mother's gonna keep baby cozy and warm. Love the Sativa Cross fam. Love their message, love their passion. Love their songs. Bong Ho Leo, he's a genius. Bong Ho Leo! Bong Ho Leo! Bong, bong, big, big, bong. How you doing? I'm Batman, I'm eating it up like Pac-Man, that's why I'm fat man. How you doing? Thought more people would have liked money. No, mother even, I didn't do money, did I? I didn't need it. Dun, dun, dun. Shh, listen to the bears. He cries it. Triple dubs. Let's get some of the fans in here. Stone Nation, pay it forward. Loss or G420 familiar. Shout out to the nation. Scooby Leaf. Love that group, PPP. Let's stick it on my profile, shall I? Because I'm going to smoke another Dove, you know what I mean? Shout out to the Dovey brothers. My brother Dovey Dove. Dovey, 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 Dovey. And Kirsty. The fam up in Scotland. My family profile. Shh. This is John Small. That's me. Shh. Right. Let's go and find this Ted character. Where's he at? There he is. Pothead. Look at him. Smoking weed again on Facebook.
Family profile. Shh.
Shh. John, shut up. I heard you there. Hey, up. So Bryce, still in the room. Copy the link. Actually, let me check. Placed in days. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. I love the blah, blah, blah group. I won't share it in there. They're not really about the free the weed. It is about blah, though, and I'm a lot of blah sometimes. The stone is dead. Let's stick it in my sister Laurie's group while I'm on, shall I? Right. Copy link, stick it. Up your jumper. Umpa, lumpa, stick it up your jumper. I've been live on my page for a few days. I've been coming over here and chilling in here. It doesn't seem to be as public as my page. My page is dead. You know, it gets all over. Here there's more just friends on my profile. But people, if you like the page and that, hit my profile. You know, if you like the stuff I do on my page, we're probably very similar minded, so hit me up. Lisa Rains back up and about. Puff puff past daily. My signal's so small. I passed the point to the other hand. I saw that was a Ganji Lovers post, that was class. Shout out to the Ganji Lovers, my brother Brandon. My signal's so small. I passed the point to the other hand. I've lost track, where am I at? Just go on the page, I told you. One hour, cheers Deborah. One hora. Welcome everyone. Just give a quick share, I'm just having this joint. Wishing all of my American fam a very happy 4th of July. The day that you fought to free the weed and that. And the Boston Tea Party was really about freeing this beautiful plant and that, because the king was going to tax the shit out of it. The next year, he started a revolution. I think we should start that revolution all over again.
You say you want a revolution.
Where's the okay, that?
You say you want a revolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world. Shoo-be-doo-ra, bomba, shoo-be-doo-ra. You tell me that it's evolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world. Talk about destruction. Don't you know that you can count me out? Don't you know it's gonna be alright? Don't you know it's gonna be alright? Alright.
Constitution. You say you got a real solution. I need to learn the rest of that. I love that song. Oh, you know, we all want to change the world. People come in, they have any suggestions, mostly appreciated. So my brain's like really, really just foggy as today. I think the sun's melted it a bit. I'm gonna get medicated before I go to bed. Sleep, 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 sleep for a week. In your ears to deal with the pain, I suggest you take a big fat hit on your big fat spliff, bong, blunt, dab rig, banger, wherever it is you like to slam her with, slam her right now. Reminds me of another hard song I've been trying to learn. Oh, Jeremy, I need to send you that song, don't I? It didn't save down to my phone, so I need to go and get it sorted. I'm gonna make some room in my phone. I don't worry, bro. Somebody said you had a new friend. Does she love you better than I can? Sky over my town. I know where you are, I bet she's around. I know it sounds stupid, but I just gotta see for myself. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Why don't you see me? And I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy you're taking home. I'll keep dancing on my own. I just wanna dance all night. I'm so messed up, it's out of line. Stilettos and broken bottles are spinning around in circles, and I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, I'm right over here, why don't you see me? Oh, and I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy. If I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're told before we get too old. Show me a garden that's bursting into life. Colin Scott does an awesome version of that. The monsters are in the room. How goes it, monsters? How are you? Not being bullied by the poet, I hope, today. No, I haven't, Deborah. No, I've been learning and doing that much of the stuff. No, I haven't. All of these ideas, all of these things I've got to get done. Happy 4th of July, Curtis. I've been telling everyone, you know this, you saw the original CBD News 420, so I don't need to explain to you all about how the original revolution, the War of Independence itself, was fought to free the plant from the King of England. Like, we know the true history, the hidden history, the real history of the world. We're not blind by it, like the sheep, you know. So I'm just reminding people of that on this, as it is still 4th of July here too, for the next 7 minutes. Mad love, Brian. Hi, Curtis. Much love to my sister Holland. I haven't spoken to you proper for ages. We'll have to catch up proper, you know. Rather than throw this, but you know what I mean? The boat might break again. Epic fail there, Mark. Epic fail. From a prison cage. take down the truthers and anyone that spreads those facts. Perhaps we might even fake a little Sauron attack at HQ, just as a social experiment to see what the fake of bookness can do. Roger Waters wrote that. Roger Waters writes all of them ones. Hi Mikey V, I've just been talking about Bongholio quite a bit. You're appearing quite a bit in my little things. I need to learn the chords off you for smoke a marijuana the American way. I smoke about an ounce of weed a day. I don't care what the government has to say. Thank God for cannabis. That's because it's how you want it. And I don't know why I can't see what you're playing. They all need to come to me. I need to learn everything that you're doing. I need to be like the bong hole Leo of the UK. And I'm going to get me an 8-foot bong. Walk around singing Bongholio cover songs. I'm gonna be the Bongholio tribute act for the northeast of UK. And my big hashtag they shall grow banner that I carry around with my guitar and that. For my interview on the 4th day of July, a personal man, he questioned me until I nearly cried. He made me fill in forms until I shook with fear about the colour of my toilet roll and if my cousin's queer. Here's your gold watch, he said, the shackles for your chains, and your piece of paper that says you left here sane. And if you've a son that wants a good career, well, just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. He asked me how many jobs I'd had before. He nearly had a heart attack when I answered four jobs in 20 years. No, this could never be, 'cause we only take on men that work until they die. Here's your gold watch, he said, the shackles for your chains, and your piece of paper that says you left here sane. And if you've a son that wants a good career, well, just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. He took me outside to where the gravestones stand in line. He said, this is where we bury them, in Quickstone and in Lyme. And if you come to work for us, this you must agree, that if you're going to die, please do it during tea break. Here's your gold watch, he said, shackles for your chains, and your piece of paper that says you left here sane. And if you've a son that wants a good career, but just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. This story that you've heard, it may seem rather queer, but it is the truth, you would be surprised to hear. I did not want a job upon the board. I just wanted to take a broom and sweep the bloody floors. But here's your gold watch, he said, and the shackles for my chains, and the piece of paper that says I left there sane. And if I've a son, he said, that wants a good career, I just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. Like a rabbit-trousered philanthropist. great read if anybody, or audio book. Check it out, The Rabbit Crowd of Philanthropists. Hi Jake, how goes it, bro? I've just been singing about your cousin, man. Much love always. Much love to the kids and the wife. Paper holds their folded faces to the floor, and every day the paper boy brings more. And if the dam bursts many years too soon, and if there is no room upon the hill, and if your head explodes with dark forebodings too, I'll see you on the dark side of the moon. The lunatic is in my head. The lunatic is in my head. You raise the blade, and throw away the key. There's someone in my head, but it's not me. And if the dam bursts many years too soon, and if there is no room upon the hill, and if the banjoing starts singing songs to Tony, I'll see you on the dark side of the moon. Oh. I'm not frightened of dying. Any time will do. Sure. I know, big man, I've always been mad, like most of us. Sorry, sir. You're not married when you are mad. Dark side of the moon. As a matter of fact, it's all light. Dedicate that song to my brother Tony Loon. Hashtag free the loon. Check out this page, people. Check out my brother Tony Loon's page. Hit up with a like and a share. Love jamming out. Love it. Free the plant, man. The size of that. Goodbye. Goodbye, grey hair. I'm ripping you out today. I'm just a regular child.
joke. With a regular job, I'm your average white suburbanite slob. I like football and porno and books about war. I got an average house with a nice hardwood floor. My wife and my job, my kids and my car. My feet on my table with a Cuban cigar. But sometimes that just ain't enough to keep a man like me interested. Oh no, no way, I gotta go out and have fun at someone else's expense. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. I drive really slow in the ultra-fast lane while people behind me are going insane. I'm an asshole. I'm the world's biggest asshole. I use public toilets and I piss on the seat. I walk around in the summertime saying, how about this heat? I'm an asshole. I'm the world's biggest asshole. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get myself a 1967 leather auto convertible, hot pink with a whiskered hubcap, and all leather county with a big brown baby sea lights for headlights. Yeah. I'm gonna drive around that baby 150 miles per hour, sucking down quarter pounds of cheeseburgers from McDonald's in the old fashioned, non biro girl of old South Brooklyn days. When I'm done sucking down those grease balls, I'll wipe my mouth with an American flag. Nuclear weapons, that's right, we got the bomb. You can have all the democracy you want. You can have a big democracy tank, walk right through the middle of your Tiananmen Square, and it ain't gonna make a lick of difference, but we got the bomb, okay? John Wayne's not dead, he's frozen. And as soon as we find a cure for cancer, we're gonna thaw out the Jupiter, gonna be pissed off, you know why? Have you ever taken a cold shower? Well, multiply that by 50 million times, that's something the Duke's gonna be, and you know why? He didn't even have to die in the first place. So we got a cure, man, we got a cure for that cancer. Got a big blunt bomb, a big fat case of whiskey, with a drive down to Texas. Meet up with priest in the room. No, I'm gonna free a player, man. Yeah, I'm gonna stay true to who we are. Cause we know, man, we know we're all assholes. And it's okay to be an asshole sometimes. A-S-S-H-O-L-B. I'm an asshole, and I'm proud to be.
Got to run, thanks for coming by, Jake. Much love to the Jake, to follow our old fan. To the wrong chord. Thank you. What should I write a song about? It's 4th of July. Oh, if I start writing a song about that, I'll end up talking about it really being about freeing the way. Heads in the clouds, mate. Tumbling down the road like an alien. I like that. Right, an alien. An alien coming to the planet Earth on the 4th of July. Let's see what I was doing. Thank you.
I was stumbling down the road like an alien, hiding out in the trees like a chameleon. They couldn't see me watching their ceremony. They breed like mice, and they think they're nice, despite being people on ice. Dissecting their lives, I wonder why. Try to genetically enhance an ape. Maybe that was the complete mistake, to make them a little more extraterrestrial. They took their vehicle and headed out into space. They said, hey, we own this place. For me to just head home and leave these apes to get drunk and stoned. Leave them in the stone ages, locked up in their little cages, saying, hey, you gotta be like this. It's no use, you got to not resist. The devil's in the details. It's an alien epic fail. Take another hit and learn from it. Jeremy Johnson and Jeremy Quayle, how have you both been? Jeremy's smoking on Lino G. That sounds rather nice to me. And April Oso, how goes you? I'm just drifting through these little chords that fell out a moment ago while I was on the other guitar. I've been sat baking for a bit. I got to drift in a jet. Oh, it's so potent. Oh, it's so potent. I smell the pollen in the air. Oh, it gets me up there. Keep going up. Why the fuck not? Oh, why? It's only midnight. It's only midnight. So that's all right. I'm good laying down, listening to you. Lay down music.
And I'm about to hit delete, delete. And I just delete them, buff, and they're gone. And there they are, and they're gone. And the good ones have come back. I done a love song for Jeremy the other day, and I had to come back at that one.
Thank you.
Jeez, that was Burberry's. I was doing that song for my brother Jeremy Johnson. Wish him for the Worldwide Weed Army, man. Best group on Facebook. Just the best group on Facebook, I'll say it. Much love always, Jeremy. Jeremy too. The Guru Tulu. Blaze up before bed, blaze up before bed. Welcome, Gakkaz. Paul, welcome. I'm chilling, it's like very late. Hi Paul, where are you from, bro? I'm part of the, you know, this like worldwide community on this Facebook. That's what I love about it. I know some people come on that don't speak English and stuff. And I wish I could speak more languages, like. I love language. Midnight song that I wrote a week or two ago. Gone, loop is gone. Dos horses. Yeah, I hope you are, told Deb. Hi Sandra, love you sis. Dos, right. De. Zwei. Zwei hours. Have you tried playing? No, no, not really, no. I've been dead lazy, really. Nice one. Hey Scott, how goes the wolf pack? So I've squat down in the Save the Wild Army feed. I love General Joe, man. They talk about some very in-depth stuff. They're like, you know what, they're just against government. And yeah, man. Oh, these are all my partners in crime right here. Randy, I haven't seen Randy much actually. I haven't been on the book that much, to be honest, Scott. We chill, we have fun. We not it. We free God's weed, as Randy likes to remind the world, Scott.
Thank you.
2 hours, maybe 5 minutes. Don't know, haven't looked for a long time. 8 minutes. Hope everyone is having a wonderful 4th of July. John singing about the song about prohibition. Hi, welcome back, Bri. I'm about to sing a song about prohibition. Restriction. I smoke weed every day. Smoke weed every day. It's the best fucking way. Look at the way it helps me stay. Remember, you don't know my pain. You don't know my pain! Making up songs into the wee hours. Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see the troubles are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name. You wanna be where you can see the troubles are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name. Cheers, everyone. I know Scott's hitting it. Making your way in the world today. Yellow, mellow, yellow. You know, I keep trying to do that, don't I? I know. Because I used to have a higher voice than I've got now, but I used to. I'm just mad about saffron. Saffron is mad about me. I'm just mad about a saffron. And she's just mad about me. They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly.
They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. He's so mellow, oh so yellow, electrical pineapple. It's gonna be the very next craze. Electrical pineapple. It's bound to be the very next phase. They'll call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. They'll call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. They'll call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. Because he's so mellow, oh so yellow. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. They call it mellow yellow, quite rightly. Because they're so mellow, such a lot of mellow fellows. Oh yes, sometimes it comes out just like jello. That's an acid, they call it mellow yellow, yellow. I used to go right up. They call it mellow yellow. I can't find it. It's not there in my voice anymore. He's so mellow, oh so yellow. You and Tom must be having a mellow night. Cheers. Don't bogart, don't bogart that joint. Joint, 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 joint. Oh, singing the notes, it sounds like an ace. Don't bogart that joint, my friend. Best thing over me. You gotta put an American twang on when you sing this song. Don't bogart that joint, my friend. Pass it over to me. Roll another one, just like the other one. You've been hanging on to it, and I sure would like a hit. That joint, my friend, pass it over to me. Don't bogart that joint, my friend, pass it over to me. Roll another one, just like the other one. This one's about burned to the end, so come on. Your real friend. Don't bogart that joint, my friend. Pass it over to me. Oh shit, I think the bomb's just kicked in. Oh, you can keep it. Whoa, man, I need to take a breath. How many stoners have had them whiteys? Whiteys. Aren't they so psychosomatic? Don't they demonstrate the power of manifestation through the mind? just thought I'd put that out there. Follow that road down to the night sky. Follow that road down to the night sky. Where the light shine on the clouds, dancing to the sounds. Gonna follow that road down to the night sky. A family of friends waits at the end of the road. Their homes on their backs, yet they're relaxed with their load. They came here to me by the temple of the stars. thumb and a lift from all the hippies in their car. Some plant the fence and some pay the rent, but they all came with the same intentions, coming together for one moment and forever, dancing and singing in the sun and the weather. Follow that road down to the night sky. Walk through the fields of Babylon, pick from the trees of Babylon. Gonna follow that road down, see what I might find. Follow that road down, follow that road down, follow that road down to the night sky. The night sky. Glastonbury. That song's about Glastonbury, it's about Glastonbury Festival. Last weekend was the Glastonbury Festival. And Glastonbury Festival decided to use 5G. So EE ran 5G. All the signals, so everybody could pick up in the middle of these farmlands. They installed 5G at the Glastonbury Festival. People were reporting really severe nosebleeds, headaches, nausea. That wasn't because they were all smashed on drugs. So people that are trying to kick up a fuss about this, like, people need to be aware of that stuff going on. Hey, welcome back, Robin. I'm just following that road down to the night sky. Plugged in this guy and started getting stuck in it. It's been 7 hours and 15 days since you took your love away. I go out every night and cover my lungs all day. Jesus. Oh, that hit the spot. Drifting, isn't it fun? DMT dumped into my brain. Yeah, cannabis can do that, you know. Got to dump a load of DMT, you just have to cough up the right time. It's been 7 hours and 15 days since you took your love away. I go out every night and smoke weed all day since you took your love away. But since you've been gone, I can do whatever I want.
can eat my dinner in a fancy restaurant, but nothing, so nothing can take away these blues, because nothing compares, nothing compares to you. It's been so lonely without you. Nothing can stop these lonely tears from falling. Tell me, baby, where did I go wrong? I can put my arms around every girl that I choose, but she just reminds me of you. I went to Dr. Strange, guess what he told me? Guess what he told me? Said, Ted, you better try to have fun no matter what you do. But he's a fool, cause nothing compares, nothing compares to you. Nothing compares, nothing compares to you. I know that living with me, baby, was sometimes hard, but I'm willing to give it a try. Nothing compares, nothing compares to you. Now it's time to say.
Now it's time to turn out the light. And it's time, because I've got one hit left on my split. So early start in the morning, I've got a load of spliffs to re-roll. Happy 4th of July, hope you all had a blessed blaze one. Make sure you have a Funky Freaky Friday, because it is now Funky Freaky Friday here. So happy Funky Freaky Friday, fam. Get funky. Free the skunk. E little monkey. Peace out. Live in the love. Love your life and learn to free the skunky little monkey.